choose Python language for automation testing. So we all know that Java is commonly considered for most of automation testing tools. But why Python and why to consider this language as well? Let's try to understand the importance of Python first. So Python is easy to learn and understand. So you might be aware of another programming languages like Java, JavaScript, C++ from your college days, but Python is the easiest language than all the remaining programming languages we have in the world. You will know that soon when I start teaching Python basics, that why this Python is very easy to learn and understand. So the one straightforward reason is that it is simpler to code. So if you take 5 lines to complete one logic in another programming languages, in Python you can wrap that logic in just 2 lines. Okay, there are many instances where you can achieve the same goal with reduced effort and with reduced coding. Okay, and for the beginners who do not have any knowledge on programming skills, this is the best language to start with. And more importantly, we all know that world is moving towards artificial intelligence, data sciences with machine learning. So Python is one of the commonly used programming language when you want to implement artificial intelligence in your applications, because this is a powerful tool which exposes a lot of capabilities and techniques for artificial intelligence. So that's the reason most of the projects are now moving towards Python to achieve this data science and machine learning in their projects. So obviously, when the development is done in Python, the testing industry also will slowly move towards using the same programming language, because people want to maintain same stack, either it could be development or testing. So that's the reason Python gonna play a crucial role in the future in terms of artificial intelligence. And at the same time, this will be the common pick for all your automation testing tools as well. Okay, and less competition. If there is a job notification on Selenium Java, there will be hundreds of applications for one job. But whereas if there is a job on Selenium Python, you will not even get 10% of applications of what you get for Selenium Java, because there is lack of skills in the market for Selenium Python, and at the same time, Python jobs are booming up. So all these features made Python a mandatory skills to have, not only for development, but also for test automation projects. Of course, Java stands on top in usage, but Selenium Python combination is rapidly growing, and this skill will keep your profile in front of queue in market for sure. Okay, so now we will see why to choose Selenium when there are different automation tools available in the market. So to keep it simple and straight, Selenium is an open source tool. That means you can download it for free without paying, and people can start working on it right away with just one click download from their official website. And more importantly, Selenium can be coded in multiple languages. You can write your Selenium code in Java, Python, JavaScript, C#, Ruby. That's cool, right? No other tool in the market have this feature. And also, you can run your test cases in different operating systems as well. I did not document here, but you can download the resources from my next lecture, that Selenium can be run in Windows, Mac, and Linux as well. So this is the only tool which supports multiple operating systems. Now there are different tools like Protractor, Appium. So these also support multiple operating systems. But do remember that basic wrapper is Selenium for those tools as well. So those are like wrappers which are written top over Selenium, but underlying code is still Selenium. Okay, so that's a pretty straightforward answer, like why we have to choose Selenium WebDriver for front-end automation. And we also seen why we have to choose Python to code our Selenium. Now, this is one of the most famous question as most of my students have. I'm already aware of Selenium Java. Should I consider learning Selenium Python? Yes. The existing knowledge of Selenium Java will help you to only write one standalone automation test, but in real time, if you want to work on Selenium Python projects, there are a lot of other things like building frameworks and unit testing frameworks are also there. In Selenium Java, there is a TestNG and JUnit as a testing framework. Similarly, for Python, there are different unit testing frameworks. You need to know all this to develop an end-to-end real-time framework in industry standards. So that knowledge will not help you. This is the basic thing I want to clear to my students. And coming to course prerequisite, this course clearly assumes that you need not have any prior knowledge in Python or even in Selenium. Okay, every topic, including Python programming, is taught from scratch with so many real-time examples. You see that how this course is organized? I clearly shown that this course is completely break down into three modules. So we will first start with module one and we will go on with Python basics from scratch. Okay, I will start from the point where I will show how to install Python in your system. From there, I will teach all the basics required for our automation. But do remember that Python is a world in itself. We just cannot cover everything in this course, but what all topics required for automation framework building, all those topics are clearly covered in our module 1. So just assume that topics necessary for Python automation is being covered, and that's up to 30% of our course. And thereafter, once you are clear with Python, then only we will move to implement and develop Selenium test cases in our module 2. So here where you will feel little comfortable if you are already aware of Selenium Java. So it will be very quick for you to learn. And in this module, we will go through all the concepts related to Selenium and we will build so many real-time exercises as part of this module. So by end of this module, you will be knowing each and every method of Selenium in Python language. And here comes the actual interesting part, which is module 3 of Python framework development. Okay, so you need to know a testing frameworks. First of all, there is a testing framework called PyTest in Python. First, we will learn what is that framework and we will go through so many important concepts of that. And thereafter, we will see how to log in Python and how to drive data from Excel to your Python test cases. And then we will build one end-to-end Python framework from scratch using all the Python object-oriented principles we learnt in module 1. Okay, so we will go through page object mechanism, there are a lot of things which required from framework development until report generation and integration to Jenkins. Everything will be covered in module 3, but for that you have to have knowledge on module 1 Python, because we will be implementing a lot of object-oriented principles of Python when developing the framework. And all those I already discussed in module 1. So you can start this course without any prior knowledge on any programming knowledge. So start in the sequence. By end of this course, you will be able to develop a robust Python Selenium framework from scratch with lot of automation test cases. Okay, so count on me, and that's an ultimate goal of this complete course. Alright, so that's pretty much about this lecture, and I hope I have cleared most of your questions, what you are looking for before we get started with our learning. So in our next lecture, let's start with module 1, Python programming, and we will begin with installing Python in our machines and we'll take it from there. Alright, thank you and wish you all the best in this new journey. See you in the next lecture.